Superstar.
Ooh.
Yes, we'll upgrade you. Here we go. Yeah, we see all the shoulder action. We see that shoulder action. I saw. Okay, okay. This is CJ Sapong. He is number 17, if you don't know. Philadelphia Union. All right, so y'all be sure to check him out. You usually have a game coming up soon.
Yeah, this Saturday.
All right.
Talent Energy Stadium, 5 o'clock.
Y'all better come on. Come on, check him out. So, you know, we were talking a little bit about the gradation, moving from being a young soccer player, a football player, then moving into college, mm-hmm. and then moving into the pros. And so we do have some people who are watching us who either are interested in making that transition themselves or who have children
mm-hmm.
who are talking about it. Yeah. I know for me as a female, I came in an era where kind of after high school, there wasn't much to do with female sports.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of on that cusp
yeah.
where it was like either you're going to go for the Olympics, there were some scholarships, but I know people are looking, yes, don't let the baby face fool you. But as a male, growing up playing sports, was moving into the pros something that you always thought about or dreamt about?
I always dreamt about it for sure. I did not always think it would be possible.
Mm-hmm.
Looking back, and I see all the times in my backyard that I was envisioning being a professional, and actually many dreams that I've had of games that, you know, I'm on the field and I realized, oh wow, I dreamt this when I was 9.
Wow.
You know,
yeah.
a lot of those moments. And, you know, that's one thing that I try to use when I do clinics and
mm-hmm.
different types of events with the youth.
Mm-hmm.
The importance of visualization,
yes.
because I wasn't exactly a very confident kid,
yes.
but because soccer was my passion, it allowed me to visualize it
mm-hmm.
in almost everything that I did, whether it was even on the field or off the field.
Okay.
And when I was on the field, I was emulating my favorite players, and you know,
such as
Pele was obviously one,
mm-hmm.
Cristiano Ronaldo,
mm-hmm.
Zlatan Ibrahimovic, who happens
mm-hmm.
to be in the league I play in now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so those things, to think that I would, Thierry Henry, to think that as I was playing these players on a video game, and would literally put the controller down, go to the backyard, put my jersey on with their name on it, and
yes.
kick against my parents' garage. Sorry about that.
Right.
You know? Lots of dents in the garage, but that's another thing that, you know, because you had said also, not only is it about the youth and their individual approach, but it's also the support system
that's
that the
right.
family provides. Yeah, I got yelled at, but ultimately they continue to allow me to let that creativity flow.
Yes.
You know, they were perfect in the way they encouraged me,
mm-hmm.
but they never made me feel like I had to do it at
yes.
the same time.
Yes.
Everything was, it made me feel like it was my decision.
Good.
And through the years of going from travel soccer, select soccer in the
mm-hmm.
neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
you know, to college, to pro. Every stage has its demographic, right?
Okay.
And you have the movers and shakers. You, that kid from the third street down who's
mm-hmm.
like really good, all the parents are talking about them. And one thing that I, in hindsight, have noticed is when parents get too involved and want to live literally vicariously
yes.
through their child, those are the teammates that I remember when I was younger growing up that had the toughest time enjoying
mm-hmm.
playing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I liken it to how I feel sometimes now, the pressure
yes.
and having to perform and worrying about what the next person is going to say. Because I grew up allowing myself to just be free and internalize my experience,
mm-hmm.
I can kind of wash away those feelings when they come up in a game.
Okay.
Yeah, they'll be there for the first 5 minutes of the game,
right.
but as I get into the mix of everything, it slowly goes away. And you know, if I'm fortunate, I get into that zone state where
yeah.
nothing can touch me.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah.
from kicking the ball against the garage
mm-hmm.
and mom and dad driving 2 hours every weekend somewhere
mm-hmm.
For me to play a game. It's definitely as I moved along the ranks, if you will, as much as the environment changed, it was those deep core values that I got when I was younger that always stayed the same. And every environment had its challenge,
mm-hmm.
but with that internal set there, I was always able to overcome. And once you overcome it once, you have that confidence and you're like, okay.
That's right.
Yeah, started actually welcoming change.
You okay. know,
it became fun for me.
Mm-hmm.
That's something that I definitely pride myself on now, where, again, even off the field, if a trial or a tribulation presents itself, it's not, oh no, this sucks, oh mm-hmm. wow, why is this happening to me? It's, okay, how am I going to get around this one?
Yep.
You know?
Yeah.
So it's a beautiful thing. And I thank you for having me on the show, because, again, saying that out loud mm-hmm. allows me to see my story and feel my story, and, you know, I feel even more energized now and moving forward.
Good.
That's cool.
I'm just wondering what age you were when you were envisioning being on Dr. Walls and Friends.
Oh, man. That must have been a past life. This is magic. Some magical is going on right
That's
now.
Right.
I'm telling y'all.
That's right.
Just keep tuning in.
Yes.
We definitely provided a catalyst to, you know, the next level of growth. And, you know, whatever that leads to, I feel like we're just willing to take in whatever light comes from it and,
mm-hmm.
and enjoy it and experience
yeah.
fully.
Well, I'm glad that you mentioned the word growth, because we're going to take a quick commercial break. But when we come back, we're going to talk about some sacred seeds.
Mm.
All right.
Sounds great.
Mm-hmm. You know, that's like that Jack and the Beanstalk growth.
Mm, that's what we're reaching
that's
for.
That's what we're going for?
That's what we're reaching for.
All right. Keep rising to the top. Give it all you got.
Ooh.
All right. All right. Oh,
man.
We'll be back in a moment on Dr. Walls and Friends.
Walls and Friends.
Dr. Walls and Friends.
Dr. Walls and Friends.